Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sapna Dadwal. I'm working as a professor in the Department of Management. This is my 10th lecture of Business Law. This subject is taught in BBA 4th semester. The topic I'm going to cover in this lecture are definition of contract of bailment, features of bailment, kinds of bailment, duties of bailer, rights of bailer. Now I am starting with contract of bailment. The word bailment has been derived from the French word that is called as bailer, which means to deliver. So bailment therefore means delivery of property or goods in trust to another for a special purpose and for a limited period of time. According to section 148 of the Act, bailment is the delivery of goods by one person to another for some purpose upon a contract that they shall, when the purpose is accomplished, be returned or otherwise disposed of according to the direction of the person delivering them. So it is very clear from the above definition, the person who is delivering the goods is called as bailer. And the person to whom the goods are being delivered is called as bailee. I'm giving you an example of the contract of bailment. For example, A handovers a piece of cloth to B, a tailor, for making a shirt. So this is a contract of bailer. This here, the cloth is given for a special purpose. That special purpose is for making a shirt. And A is a bailer because he is giving a good. And B is a bailee, and here the cloth is given for a specific period of time, and after that specific period of time, the bailee has to return back the goods to the bailer. So this is an example of bailer. Now one more question arises: does the deposit of money constitute bailment? When we deposit money into the bank, does it constitute a bailment, or it is a contract of bailment or not? So I want to clear that bailment is concerned only with goods. Section 27 of the Sale of Goods Act says, and it defines goods as every kind of movable property other than money and actionable claim is called as goods. So in a contract of bailment, it is very clear the goods is given to bailee by the bailer. So when a depositor brings money to the bank, it can be termed as a contract of loan only, not as a contract of bailment. So deposit of money doesn't constitute a bailment. So it is a contract of loan. It's very clear from this. Now the next topic is features of bailment. The first one is agreement, second one is delivery of goods, then movable property, definite purpose, then return of specific goods. I'm starting with first, agreement. There must be an agreement between the bailer and bailee. This agreement may be either express or implied. However, the bailment may be implied by law also. Now second is delivery of goods. We have already seen from the example, a contract of bailment required the delivery of goods by one person to other. It involves only the change of possession of goods, not ownership. Ownership remains with the bailer, or the person who is delivering goods for a specific purpose. Then third is movable property. Goods refers to, I have already explained what good refers to. Good refers to every kind of movable property other than money and actionable claims as per the section 27 of Sale of Goods Act 1930. So goods means every kind of movable property other than actionable claim and money. Hence bailment of immovable property like land and building cannot be made. The next essential is definite purpose. So in bailment, the goods are delivered to the bailee for some specific purpose, which is generally in view of both bailer and bailee. The purpose may include repair of goods, or changing their form, such as tailoring or carpentry, etc., or repair, like when we are delivering goods from baler to baler. For example, I've given my car to mechanic for the repair purpose, so this is a contract of bailment. Now the next one is return of specific goods. The goods which from the subject matter of bailment must be returned to the bailer, otherwise disposed of according to the direction of bailer. The next feature is essentials of valid contract. So the contract of bailment must have all the essentials of valid contract. All the essentials of valid contract I have discussed in my lecture 1. You can see the lecture 1 for knowing the essentials of valid contract. Now the second one is, seventh essential of the contract of bailment is ownership not transferred. So in the contract of bailment, ownership is not transferred by the bailer to the bailee. Only the possession is transferred, that is for a limited period of time for completing a specific purpose. Now the next topic is kinds of bailment. The bailment may be of two types. For the first one is on the basis of reward, and the second one is on the basis of benefit. So I'm starting with first, on the basis of reward. On the basis of reward, the bailment can be divided into two types. The first one is gratuitous bailment. The second one is non-gratuitous bailment. A gratuitous bailment is that in which neither the bailer nor the bailee is entitled to any remuneration. It is a bailment without any charges, reward, or consideration. Then non-gratuitous bailment. A non-gratuitous bailment is that in which either the bailee or the bailer is entitled to some remuneration. It is bailment which involves reward or payment of charges or consideration. Then second main types of bailment is, a bailment is also divided on the basis of benefit. On the basis of benefit, the bailment may be divided into three types. The first one is bailment for the exclusive benefit of the bailer. It is a bailment where goods are delivered by the bailer to the bailee only for his benefit. Bailee doesn't derive any benefit from this type of bailment. Now the second one is bailment for exclusive benefit of the bailee. It is the bailment where the goods delivered by the bailer to bailee for exclusive benefit of bailee only. So in this type of bailment, bailer doesn't derive any benefit from the contract of bailment. Now the third is mutual benefit, bailment for a mutual benefit. It is the bailment where goods are delivered by the bailer to bailee for the mutual benefit of both of them. Both derive benefit from such contract of bailment. Now, the next topic is duties of bailer. First one is to disclose known fault. So it is the duty, it is the first and foremost or very important duty of the bailer to disclose the known faults of the goods which are being bailed by him to the bailee, or which are being transferred to the bailee. If he doesn't make such a disclosure, he is responsible for any damages caused to the bailee directly from such faults. For example, A lends or deliver a horse to B under the contract of bailment, and he doesn't tells to B that the horse is a very vicious one. The horse runs away and B is injured, and so in this case A is responsible to B for the damage or for the injuries of the B. He has to pay for the damages and all the expenses of the B's injury. Then second one is to bear extraordinary expenses. The bailee is bound to bear ordinary and reasonable expenses of the bailment, but for any extraordinary expenses the bailer is responsible. Again, example, A lends or gives his horse to beef under the contract of bailment for 2 days. The feeding charges are to be paid by B. But the horse meets with an accident, then all the expenses is to be bear by A. Now the third one is to indemnify Bailey for loss in case of premature termination. In case of a gratuitous bailment, a contract can be terminated by bailer at any period, at any time. But in such a case, the loss accruing to Bailey from such premature termination of the contract by the bailer shall have to indemnify the Bailey if he has suffered loss because of this premature termination of the contract. Then, fourth one is to receive back the goods. So, it is the duty of the bailer to receive back goods when the Bailey returns them after the expiry of the term of the bailment or when the purpose for which bailment was created has been accomplished. If the bailer refuses to receive back the goods, the Bailey is entitled to receive compensation from the bailer for the necessary expenses of custody. Now the last duty of the bailer is to indemnify the Bailey. So where the title of the bailer to the goods is defective and the Bailey suffers a loss as a consequence, the bailer is responsible to the Bailey for any loss which the Bailey may sustain by reason that the bailer was not entitled to make bailment or to receive back the goods. So here, in this case, the bailer has to indemnify Bailey or compensate all the losses to Bailey. Now the next topic is rights of bailer. The first one is a bailer can enforce Bailey's duties. The bailer has a right to enforce the duties of the Bailey in case he is neglecting the duties of the Bailey or he is using goods being bailed to him. He is making an unauthorized use of the goods, or he is mixing the bailed goods with his own goods. So in such cases, the bailer can enforce Bailey and can demand damages if he suffers loss because of this. Then second one is termination of contract of bailment. A bailer has a right to terminate the contract of bailment if the Bailey doesn't act with regard to the goods bailed or with the conditions of the contract of bailment. For example, A has given or lends his horse to B under the contract of bailment, and A has lent a horse to B for his own use, whereas in this case B is using a horse for the carriage purposes. In such case, A can terminate the contract because B is using unauthorized. B is using horse without the consent of the A, or he is not following the terms and conditions of the contract of bailment. Then, to demand back goods. In case of gratuitous bailment of goods, the bailer has right to demand back goods at any time, even though the goods has been bailed for a specific period of time. But in such case, if the Bailey has suffered a loss, then bailer has to indemnify the Bailey for that particular loss. Then, next one is to claim increase or profit from goods bailed. It is the right of the bailer to claim increase of profit on the goods bailed by him to the bailee, and the bailee is bound to deliver the profit or increase in goods to the bailer. These are the questions which are related to the above topics. If any query is there related to above topics, you can always contact me. If there is any writing mistake, then please ignore that mistake. Thank you so much.